Hey guys, Jay VanGorden here with FCP Euro, working on this 2013 Volvo XC60. Going to be replacing the Haldex fluid, doing a service on the Haldex unit. This is a 13 is the first year for the Haldex 5 system, so it's a little simpler compared to some of the earlier generations where it had a filter and the AOC pump was a little bit more difficult to remove. This one is very straightforward. It's a service that most people could do in their driveway or at home. And basically what we have here is the Haldex service kit for this vehicle. It includes a syringe, some oil, some O-rings for the pump, a new drain plug, and two new bolts for the pump itself. Some of the tools you're going to need are a quarter inch drive ratchet, a quarter inch drive extension, preferably at least a 6 inch, a 10 millimeter socket, preferably deep, some pliers, a good flashlight is going to help, a flat surface or something similar to a dime. We're going to use a dime in this video, and this is going to be used in a drain plug. It's very difficult to get a screwdriver, a flathead screwdriver in there that's wide enough and that is shallow enough to fit in the area that we're going to be working in. So a dime is going to work. And also, like I said, that's part of the kit is the syringe, and this is to refill the fluid. All right, let's get started. All right, so the first thing you want to do is get underneath the car. Jacking it up, maybe put it on jack stands or ramps, whatever you have, is definitely going to make this a little easier just so you can get more clearance. Now the car, we're using a lift right now just for demonstration purposes, but now the car is jacked up. The Haldex system's right here. Just to give you an overview, this is the Haldex controller. This is the AOC pump. The fill plug that we're going to be using today is way back here. It's in an awkward spot just because you can't really get to it too easy with the exhaust in a way. So that's why we're going to use like any type of flat edge surface. A coin always works best on these cars. But to start, so the first thing I want to do is remove the connector for the Haldex pump because we're going to be taking that pump off next. So just unclip it. Now there's going to be two 10 millimeter bolts that hold this pump on. We're going to remove those. So we'll start on the top. So I just cracked it loose and I'm just spinning it out with my hand. While I'm taking this out, just a mental note, you know, on these cars, you do see these pumps fail from time to time. So if you're trying to do a little bit more preventative maintenance, you're taking this pump out anyway, so it's not a bad idea to replace it at this time. This one's working fine. This is my personal car. And I'm gonna leave it in. So now that the pump is unbolted, we're just gonna wiggle this side to side. You're gonna need a drip pan. Just raise it up, because once we take this pump out, fluid's gonna come out. So not too much fluid comes out. Now again, this is the generation 5 Haldex, so this is a lot easier to service compared to previous generations. This generation actually doesn't have a filter. If you have an external filter up on the side, it's usually located right here. That's going to be on the generation 4. So you could use that as an indication which generation that you have in your car, or you could just go to our website, look at the application guides and all of our Haldex service kits, and that'll tell you exactly what your car came with. All right, while the fluid, the old fluid, is draining out of the Haldex, save some time. We're going to take the old pump, and you're going to see there's a little bit of a screen on here. So it doesn't look too bad, but so we're going to take this screen off. We're going to clean that out, and we're also going to clean up the outside of the pump, all the sealing surfaces, and put on two new O-rings. So we just got the sock off, and just a quick note. So, I mean, Volvo doesn't specify servicing the Haldex system on these cars. If you look up their maintenance, it's not in there. It's not something that, you know, that they suggest that you do there or that's needed on these cars. So this car has 120,000 miles on it. And, you know, just for comparison, I mean, look at the sludge that's built up on this slack. You know, so we want to clean all this out. And then even here, look on, you know, the outskirts of it, you know, I'm going to show the oil, you know, new oil versus old in just a moment. But, you know, this is what happens when you don't change your oil on systems like this. You'll build up all types of, you know, hardcore debris. This is the stuff that gets inside the system and clogs it up and prevents, you know, or causes failure.
Look at this gunk.
So now we're back under the car. I just want to wipe my finger on the bottom edge of that and see what's in there. You can see, look at this. It's all types of old fluid gunk built up. All right, guys, so we're ready to go back in with the pump. Moment of truth here. Here's the difference in fluid between what came out and what we're putting in. So, I mean, you can see just how dark and sludgy this is versus the new fluid. All right, so the pump is all clean. New oil rings, everything's lubricated. Let's go ahead and put it back into position. There it is. All right, now that the pump is bolted into place, don't forget to plug it in. Always a good idea to check out your connectors. Make sure the terminals don't have any corrosion. These look good. All right, so last is we want to fill the system up. Always a good idea to remove these or at least crack these drain the fill plugs loose before you do anything else. I did that beforehand, but just a note for you guys. So because of where this is, you can see it's right up against the exhaust and it's such a long flat surface here. Using like a flathead screwdriver, anything that's wide enough is gonna be too long. So like I said, I'm gonna use like a coin here. President Roosevelt is gonna do the trick hopefully for us. Look at that. FDR came through, baby. So it's just a plastic plug. And like I said, here's a better look at it. It's just a long flat insert there. So like I said, if you have a coin, screwdriver may not be able to get it the best just because of the length, even the stubby. It's not the best grip. And what you don't want to do is kind of get in there and then, you know, twist your screwdriver, which would damage the plastic, because that would put you in a world of problems if you can't get the fill plug off. So like I said, sounds kind of comical, but you know, any coin should do the trick. Next, take some of your brand new Haldex oil, and we're going to use a syringe that is supplied in the kit. And we're going to put some fresh new oil. And you want to fill this until it starts dripping out. It's going to pour out first, and then you're going to want to wait for it to come to a slow drip. Once it comes to a drip, put the cap on. And it's suggested to go for a test drive with the car. And what that's going to do is that's going to filter through the system all the brand new oil. And once you're done with the test drive, you're going to come back, repeat the same process, and wait for it to drip out again. And then you're all set. You're done. So take your new drain plug, put it in, grab your favorite coined president. Let's twist it back into location. There's actually a stop on this, you'll see it, so you can't over tighten it. All right, now that the plug's in, just take some brake clean, clean down the area. This way, after we run it through all the gears and bring it for a test drive, we come back. If there's any fluid that's on here, you know you have a leak somewhere. So you just want to keep a clean machine after you're done. All right, guys, that concludes the Haldex 5 system service on this 13 XC60. Again, such a simple service, very easy to do. And, you know, obviously going from this to this is going to prolong, you know, the service life of your Haldex system. Those components are very expensive, the pump, the control unit, and everything else that incorporates into the system. Very, very difficult and expensive system to maintain and replace. So, you know, changing your fluid goes a long way, and it's very simple to do. If you like this video, don't forget to hit that like button. And if you want to see more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.